Hi, welcome to Movie Review with Daniel. And today on our Throwback Thursday, I'll be doing a movie review on Priest. Priest is a 2011 American action horror film directed by Scott Stewart. The film was released on the 6th of May 2011. Beware, this movie review contains curses and spoilers. The 2011 film that retains director Scott Stewart with Paul Bettany is an adaptation of the Korean comic series of the same name by Jung Min-woo. However, The Priest of Korean Prince tells a different story than that of its Hollywood counterpart. Instead of battling fallen angels, the American priest fights beastly vampires who sleep in coffins and keep humans as pets. That said, plenty of comic book turned movie adaptations have benefited from creative liberties here and there. While Stewart's Priest has certainly taken more liberty than most, it's still possible that the final film is better for the alterations, right? Unfortunately, Prince joins other lackluster films, such as My Soul to Take, that were delayed upon completion and retrofitted with post-converted 3D to help attract audiences to a film that otherwise has very little going for it, aside from a few slow-motion heavy action set pieces. The alteration to the core Priest storyline, originally about an undead pilgrim who is reborn after merging with a spiritual force, creates one of the weirdest narrative mishmashes in recent memory. One of the most disappointing aspects of Priest is the shameless lack of world building. In case you are unfamiliar, the film takes place in a potentially fascinating alternate world where humans and beastly vampires have warred for centuries. Though the film never takes advantage of this foundation to turn tide, the church unleashes the priest, humans with superhuman-like reflexes who drive the vampires into exile. Humanity takes shelter in a large, fortified church-run cities, and instead of eradicating the vampires altogether, the creatures of the night are quarantined in concentration camp-like facility. While the priests are forced to live in obscurity since the church fears the warriors might rebel against the aging religious regime. This status quo is sustained until the vampire attack on the farming community sends Bethany's priest on a journey of revenge which opposes the will of the church leaders, who have become vain and subsequently brand priest a troublemaker, electing to ignore the vampire threat and attack the noble warrior instead. As mentioned, the film never really takes advantage of anything more than the most basic settings and story beats, never really touching on the vampire's trap. That is, there's more than one kind. The day-to-day lives of the surviving woman at work could be an interesting juxtaposition in the character of Priest, a man of faith who enjoys killing. Instead, the film focuses on the cliché story of a true man of faith who must do God's work in spite of a fascist and incompetent church organization. Even though the basic plot isn't particularly fresh, Priest has room to capitalize on its less conventional aspects, given the film's dystopian western setting and intriguing mix of modern and traditional vampire tropes. Unfortunately, the movie is too one-note to take advantage of anything but a linear race to the final Priest on vampire battle.
Thanks for watching today's review. For more interesting videos, please don't forget to like and subscribe.